We know that the question on your screen is one of the most burning ones for engineers in the AEC industry. We've heard it a million times and it keeps coming back. So, we decided to finally answer it for you in the best possible manner. This is not just another generic video. We are about to drill deep down for this one. Oh, and stick till the end for a bonus tip. So in one of our weekly interactions with our industry experts and mentors, we brought up an important question. We asked them, when you're hiring civil and structural engineers in your team, what skills are you looking for in the candidates?
Talking about civil and structural engineers in specific, the work they do already is computer bound. People used to do structural analysis on paper, and then they moved to use computer-aided graphics. So the word CAD itself has aided with computer-aided, right? So that's the next step that they went when using a technology. So the right now, the peak of technology assistance in structural engineering is BIM. So anyone who's trying to get into structural engineering or who's already in structural engineering and trying to enhance their progress in their career, I would suggest BIM, learning BIM tools, BIM processes, softwares that are BIM-enabled softwares. That should be the way that they should proceed their career towards, and that guarantees a future-proof career.
We also value technical proficiency in civil and structural engineering, a strong foundation in structural analysis, design principles, and construction methods.
Okay, so when it comes to hiring, so like right now, what we have in the current scenario is we have really freshly graduated people in India particularly. And you know, that is the first segment which comes in the mind when it comes to hiring. So usually they are really fresh with the knowledge. They know the current trends as the youth, but it really, you know, tweaks me up when they actually took some efforts to learn more about BIM or to learn more about software. So it actually makes a lot of difference, and it literally filters their CV out of it.
We need an all-rounder right now who possesses both technical as well as the new tools and new software knowledge.
Three industry experts, three top firms, and yet it all seemed to boil down to one thing, BIM. Interesting, but why is that? For us to go to the why, let's first understand the what. You'd probably know that BIM stands for Building Information Modeling. It is essentially a methodology to create and manage the digital representation of a built asset with the integration of multidisciplinary level data. Sounds complicated, right? Let us break it down for you. B stands for building. It covers all constructions in the AEC industry, from residential and industrial buildings to bridges and roads. It refers to any built form. I is for information, which encompasses a vast array of data, specifications, and details that are intrinsic to the life cycle of a building. For instance, the data you gather about a building's materials, energy performance, maintenance requirements, and so on. And then there is the M, which stands for modeling. Picture a situation where you create a highly detailed digital model of a complex infrastructure project, such as a bridge. Through BIM modeling, you can simulate various load scenarios, evaluate structural integrity, and optimize designs for cost effectiveness and safety. And that is how BIM comes together. BIM is actually what commenced the digital revolution in the AEC industry.
I can give you another example. The periods between 2005, 2010, like 15 to 20 years ago, getting into IT was the craze. Anyone who wants to start their career, they were looking at IT because IT had a lot of tough job opportunities. If you get into IT, you'll settle. And they were right. People are learning tons now. So I'm not denying that, right? So similarly, at every point of time, there'll be a change of direction in every field. And in AEC industry, architecture, engineering, and consultants or construction, BIM is that turning point. So this is still an early adoption in India. It has not matured yet, right? That is an important factor. It has not matured yet. It is still a new factor in India. It has grown to some extent in other countries, Western countries, and in Asia-Pacific countries, but it's still in an early adoption stage. So if you get into it now, the time that the industry matures, you'll be at the peak. the demand, the person who's at the maximum demand will be you. You'll be having the in-demand skills and you'll be the person leading the industry.
The current construction industry is adopting in the BIM in such a way that they are like normalizing it. Just like a normal drafting, they are just utilizing the BIM techniques as a normal protocol. So this will definitely levitate your, you know, thing. It's like if I tell you that I'm going to tell you the question paper of the 10th exam, so definitely you will score better, right? So this is what I'm telling you about how the future is going to be and how BIM will impact it. There are lots of projects who are like actually using the approach of BIM. It's not like up to the 100% till now, but in upcoming years, it's going to be. So you will get a lots of opportunities in India too. And apart from that, then there is US, UK and Saudi, like Arabic countries. They have a rapid boost in the infrastructure. So these are the main countries where there is a lots of things going on right now.
The money factor, right? So that should be a great point for convincing anyone. So if you look at any starting salary, on any field of for a civil engineer, any person, any engineer with the BIM skills, right? Not just a core BIM engineer, any structural engineer or a geotechnical engineer with the BIM skills will definitely be earning at least 40% more. Because that is the demand of the hour. Learning BIM will make you industry relevant and also time relevant. It also make you future proof.
If we are being completely honest, after watching this, even the non-AEC professionals in our team were like, oh, BIM seems to be really darn important. Okay, so here's a quick recap. BIM, being a tech-enabled methodology, is highly scalable, which opens millions of doors for you, is a standard practice followed throughout the industry, severely reduces human effort to increase efficiency, automates almost everything in the project lifecycle, and there really are not a lot of skilled BIM professionals. So we guess it is pretty clear why you should learn BIM as a civil or structural engineer. And now coming to the bonus tip. Have you ever heard about the technology adoption curve by sociologist Everett Rogers? It essentially describes the stages of technology adoption. It tells us how it always starts with the innovators, people who are tech enthusiasts, who create new concepts and like trying new things. In fact, innovators are often the initiators of change. So, if you want to be among the top 1% of the tech revolution in the AEC industry, the time is now. Take charge of your success today with Novator. Click the video on your screen to know about the career opportunities and salaries of BIM engineers. And we'll see you soon with more valuable content.